All right, it's that time. Let's put on our 1940s style fedora. Put in that press card right in the band right there. Get out our big old stogies. Munch down on it. Lefty, you gotta give me the story. I got kids to feed here. It is time for Cat Journalism Part 2. Your questions, your answers. Let's get to it. Catify the world! Last time around, we were talking about cat journalism. We were talking about the concept of going deep inside of a problem, but at the same time, keeping some subjectivity, stepping away at the same time, exploring it. That's what a journalist does. They say, just the facts, ma'am. And in gathering the facts, they uncover the story, and that's what we're gonna do. First one is from Kitty B. I have had my cat Izzy for 8 years. A couple days ago, he peed in the laundry basket. That was pretty random. We do spoil him a lot, and I noticed he did this when we ran out of his favorite food. I'm wondering if he was trying to send us a message. Here's what I like about that. What I like is you said, I noticed, meaning that you were present in that moment. Now, you did hint that it was spiteful, that it was a vengeful pee. That, in my experience, that's not something that happens. Take apart that day. Why was that day different from other days? 8 years, he never peed in the laundry basket. How many times in those 8 years did you run out of his favorite cat food? Was there fighting going on in the house? Had you gone on a trip? Were you going on a trip? Were suitcases out? Was his carrier out? Did he know he was going to the vet? What raised that level of anxiety? Because don't forget what he did. He went into a place that smelled distinctly like you. So something territorially really set him off. Cats outside the house, cats inside the house, new child. What came in there that could have spiked him? Kitty B, I want to hear from you. Don't forget to hashtag Team Cat Mojo and hashtag Cat Journalism as well. I'll get this message and we'll continue this conversation. Number two, D. Sanchez, random cat action. My two cats were walking past one another and the smaller and older one turned around and slapped the other one in the face with one paw, then the other a couple times. My big cat, dazed, walked away. So the cat boxing had never happened before or since. Parentheses, is it bad that I giggle about it as a memory? No, it's still slapstick, right? As long as no blood was drawn, it's slapstick. Let's talk about these two cats. Unless you have context, that's just your older cat having an older grouchy moment. Grumpy old men, that's what we got right here. It's just like, hey, you're invading my bubble, back the hell off. Now, how old is he? If he's older, when was the last time you had him at the vet? Senior cats have got to get in annually for a senior panel and a wellness exam, because if he's never slapped the other cat before and they've been together for so long and he's just grouchy that day, boy, he was extra grouchy, and pain will make you grouchy, believe you me. Duchess of the Ice. Hello, Duchess of the Ice. Hey Jackson, I have a random story. Jasper, my Seal Point Berman, lived to the ripe old age of 17. However, when he was about 14 or 15, he followed me into the bathroom one day, came up to me, turned around, lifted his tail, and peed, not sprayed, on my leg. It was really out of the blue, and he never did it again. What was that all about? And the other thing that you might have noticed, around 14, 15, we start to see signs of a little bit of dementia. This is what makes this one tough, is that Jasper is no longer with us, because that way we really could explore that behavior. And plus, this was a few years ago, so it's gonna be tough for you, but here are the questions you can ask yourself. Where were you? What did you do? What made him anxious? Folks, I can't stress this enough. When we talk about a cat doing something, instead of you going, man, he was pissed at me, right? Step away from that language of pissed at you. Step toward the language and toward the vibe of anxiety and stress. Cats are subject to the same kind of stress as we are. If we're working constantly and we're getting 3 hours of sleep, we're gonna do things that we might not do otherwise. Okay, folks, that's it. All three of you guys will receive handsome prizes. Hopefully, you get a better grasp on what cat journalism is. This is something I want you to pass on to your friends and neighbors and families who have cats who are creeping toward that ledge of saying, this cat's driving me crazy. Homework, people. The next time you see a random event, take it apart on paper. After you do it for a week straight, you look back on it, and it is not that same emotional thing. It is palm size. Get to the truth. Hopefully, folks, that's what you're going to do. Get to the truth. And that will make sure that your bond with your cat is still fruitful and lovely. All right, folks, if you want to find me, you can find me. Social media-wise, I really am everywhere. I'm posting every day on Twitter and Instagram and Facebook. Man, there's a lot of us on Facebook right now. Hey, don't look for me as much as you look for the rest of this community, man. We are Team Cat Mojo in full effect. Look at all these other places you can get a hold of me. Don't forget, hashtag Team Cat Mojo when you're making comments. That way I see it. Folks, from today, if you want to give me an update, hashtag Cat Journalism. I will see you next time. All light, all love, all mojo to ya. Love you. Special kudos and thanks and props go out to Motley Zoo up in Washington State. You can support them as well. Just go to the link down below here. Just so you know, Pitts Rock, man. Pitts Rock. That's right, man.